Welcome to Schoolhouse Arts Center. How are we feeling tonight?
Hey!
Welcome, my name is Zach Stern. I am the artistic director here at Schoolhouse, and I've also had the great privilege of directing The Wizard of Oz this summer. And what a show do they have for you tonight.
Right.
Would you really?
Sure,
spirit, he got no reason to be scared of nothing or no one.
You were scared. If you was a jackrabbit, well, you'd be in the next county by now.
Here. What's all this jabber-rapping when there's work to be done? I know three shiftless farmhands will be out of the job before they know it.
We're just trying to have a little fun, Miss Dale.
Farm's no place for fun. You want fun, go join the circus.
No, maybe I'll do just that. Be a strong man and see the world.
Well, don't start posing for it now. Here. Can't work on an empty stomach. Have some cookies.
Gosh.
Just wait. Well, you don't have to sit down and eat them. And see, you go feed those hogs before they worry themselves into anemia.
Yes, ma'am.
I am really, do you know what Miss Gorge said she was going to do to Toto?
Oh, dear. Stop imagining things. You always get yourself into a fray over nothing.
Oh, well, this time it's different.
Please, just help us out today. Go find yourself a place where you won't be into any trouble.
Some place where there isn't any trouble. I wonder if there is a place, Toto. There must be. Not a place you can get to by boat or train. Somewhere far from behind the moon and beyond the rain.
Bye.
appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I am so shaken by the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
If you don't eat, you'll waste away. And I hate to see it dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute?
I'm sure if Dorothy's upset with her in any way, she'll be only too glad to apologize. Yes, she can.
It's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I've laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
Was he sober?
Dorothy, Miss Belcher is very upset.
That dog's a menace to the community.
That's not true.
As an act of public service, young woman, I'm taking him to the sheriff and make sure he's destroyed.
Destroyed? Oh, Toto, you can't. Oh, you mustn't. Uncle Henry, Auntie Anne, please. You won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't, will we, Em?
Oh, please, Auntie Anne, we didn't know he was doing anything wrong. I'm the one who ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is. Surely, if she promises to give your place a boy.
If you don't hand that dog over right now, I'll bring a damage suit for them. Take your whole farm. There's a law protecting folks against dogs that bite.
Well, how would it be if she keeps him tied up? He's really gentle. Gentle folk, that is.
That's for the sheriff to decide. Here's the paper. Allow me to take him.
Yes.
What's it say, Henry?
What she said. Just what she said. You're going to have to let him go, Dorothy.
No, I won't let you.
You can't go against the law, Dorothy. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
No.
That's more like it.
No.
This is what I brought to take him in so he can't attack me again.
No, 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 I won't fight to myself. No. Oh, you're working all the way. Oh. No, Uncle Henry, Annie, Anne, please don't let him take Toto.
Give me that,
Toto. Oh, no.
Oh, Toto. It ain't no use running.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
He is your friend. We all are.
Things are bigger than all of us. Like you can't fight the law.
Let me have him, Dorothy.
Please, Uncle Henry.
That's more like it.
Put him in the basket, Henry.
No. Toto.
Elmira Gulch, just because you won't have the county doesn't mean you have the power to run the rest of us. 23 years I've been dying to tell you what I thought of you. And now, well, being a Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can. So if you don't want to hear it, you better peddle your carcass off my land.
I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Remember, I have friends in high places.
Why don't you go climb on your broomstick and go visit him?
You got that horse hitched to the wagon yet?
Oh, no. Nearly done, Mr. Gale. Nearly done.
Nearly ain't good enough. You get it done right now. Scott's getting darker every minute. Damn it, Mr.
Come inside, honey.
She had an order from the sheriff, Dorothy. What did you expect us to do? Wave a wand and make it disappear?
You still wouldn't try it.
And you stood there like you were stuffed or something.
I just couldn't think of anything. I'm sorry.
One mean old woman, and you were scared of her.
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you're worst of all. You stopped Toto from getting away, and I just hate you.
Don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel all terrible inside, like my heart was ripped right out.
I don't care. I never want to see any of you ever, ever again. Toto was the only friend I had in this world, and now he's gone, and I have no one to talk to, and no one to go on adventures with. And now I'll never see him again as long as I live. Toto? Toto? Toto, where are you? Toto! Toto! Oh, you got away from that horrible woman, you wonderful dog!
She'll be coming back for you any minute now. We've got to get away. We've got to run away. We need food for me and a bone for you, and then we're never coming back here ever, ever again.
Here, doggy, doggy. Oh, where's that dragon? Here, doggy, doggy.
I told you to get off our land, Miss Gulch.
I did, but the dog got away.
Well, I couldn't join your company much.
Where the girl is, that's where we'll find the dog. Kindly bring her out here.
You never give up, do you? Dorothy! Dorothy!
She ain't in the house, Henry. And that fresh batch of cookies is missing. My picture from the mantle, that's gone too.
Sounds like you've a runaway on your hands. Well, if she's on the road, I'll find her. and then I'll take that doll back for good.
Well, if you enjoyed your company so much, why'd you quit?
Well, don't blame me. The catch on this bat stick was faulty. It's the last time I buy anything from a charity bazaar.
Hickory!
national heroine, my dear.
Thank you.
worse than the other one was. Where's my sister?
Yonder she lies.
Where?
There.
All right. Who's the smart aleck that turned her into a house?
Not the house. Under the house.
Under the house?
Oh, I'm so sorry. It's all my fault. My house dropped on her.
Dropped your house on my sister? How could anybody be so unbelievably clumsy?
Look closer. You recognized her then?
Of course I recognized her. Who else would wear ruby slippers with those socks? Slippers. Little girl, you are about me a service. I shall donthe ruby slippers, which will make my powers greater than ever. Oh, the ruby slippers! Ow! What have you done with them? What have you done with them?
See for yourself. Step forward.
Give them back to me, or I
will... It's too late. There they are, and there they'll stay.
You stay out of this, Glinda, or I'll fix you as well. Give them back to me. Give them back. They're of no use to you. Give them back to me. Give them back. Give them back. Give them back.
Keep tight inside them. Their magic must be very powerful, or she wouldn't want them so badly.
Oh, stay on, Miss Glinda, or I will fix you, I promise.
You have no power while I'm here. Be gone before somebody drops a house on you, too.
Fair play. I'll bide my time. But as for you, my fine young lady, it's true. I can't attend to you here and now as I like. But after a suitable period of mourning, I shall have this. And my revenge, too. So just try to stay out of my way. Just try. I'll get you, my pretty. And your little dog, too.
Follow the elephant road.
Where should we go?
Pardon me. That way's a very nice way.
Who said that? Don't be silly, Toto. Scarecrows don't talk.
It puts him down that way, too.
That's funny. Wasn't he pointing the other way?
Then again, people do go both ways.
You did say something, didn't you? What's the matter? Can't you make up your mind, or are you doing that on purpose?
Well, I haven't got a brain, only straw. So, I haven't a mind to make up.
Well, how can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
Oh, well, I don't know. But some people without brains do an awful lot of talking, don't they?
Well, yes, I suppose you're right. Can't you get down?
Down? Oh, no. I got a full stomach in my back.
Oh. Is there any way you can help me?
I don't know. I'm not very worried about these things. But maybe you just bend the nail on the back and just slip right off.
I'll certainly try.
All right.
Oh, it's awful stiff nail.
There goes some of me again.
Doesn't that hurt you?
Oh, no, I just keep picking it up and putting it back in.
Well, let me help you.
Thank you. Ah, it's good to be free.
Are you all right? Oh,
did I scare you?
Oh, no, I thought you hurt yourself.
But I didn't scare you?
No, of course not.
I didn't think so. You see, I can't even scare a crow.
Boo! Boo!
Howdy, Scarecrow.
They come from miles around just to eat in my cornfields.
Hi, Scarecrow.
And laugh in my face. Scarecrow swinging on a pole to a blackbird sitting on a fence. Oh, the Lord gave me a soul, but forgot to give me all of incense.
Said the blackbird, well, 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 what in the world would you come
to say? Said a scarecrow would be clean, just a reason out the reason of the richness and the wisest.
Both the scarecrows in Kansas can do that, and the crows would be scared to pieces.
They would?
Oh, yes.
Where is this Kansas?
Oh, it's where I live. And I want to be back there so badly. I'm going all the way to the Emerald City to ask the Wizard of Oz to help me.
Oh, you're going to see a wizard? Oh, you think if I went to you, this wizard might give me some brains?
One thing to be sure. Even if he didn't, you'd be no worse off than you are now.
Oh, I suppose that's true.
You may not want to, because that got a witch mad at me. You may get into some trouble.
A witch, huh? Well, I ain't afraid of no witch. I'm not afraid of anything. Except the right match.
Well, I don't blame you for that.
Oh, but I can face the whole box of matches for the chance to get a break. Oh, look, please take me with you. I won't be any trouble because I don't need anything. And I won't manage anything because I can't win. Oh, please, won't you take me with you? Please, 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 please.
Of course.
Oh, hooray! I'm going to get me a break. Oh,
well, you're not starting off very well.
Oh, I'll try. Really, I will.
To Oz?
To Oz! I love to see the Wizard of the Wonderful Wizard of Oz. He is the Wizard of Oz, and better a Wiz than was. And better a better a Wiz than was. The Wizard of Oz is one because of the wonderful things he does. Oh. We're off to see the Wizard.
I finally found out. why it feels wonderful. I've been holding the sacks up for ages.
Oh, however did you get like this?
Well, when I was flesh and blood like you, I fell in love with a munchkin mate whose mother hated me, to stop me from marrying her daughter, she hired the wicked witch of the West to put an evil spell on my axe. And, well, when I went to chop down a tree, I chopped off my leg instead.
You chopped your own leg off?
I get fortunate. A wonderful tinsmith who made me a new leg, almost as good as the old one. Back I went to work. You know what happened then?
No.
Something terrible like that.
Well, I swung my axe and dang me if it didn't take off the other leg.
You should have gotten a new axe.
You're probably right. I got me a new leg instead. Well, back I went to work.
Well, you certainly were persistent, weren't you?
This time, I chopped off both arms.
Well, I can see how you can chop off one of your arms, but how did you manage to chop off the other one?
I told you. The axe was enchanted.
Oh! You see, Dorothy, if I had a brain, I could have figured that one out myself.
Sometimes I wish I hadn't gotten a new pair of arms from the tinsmith. The last time I swung my axe, it was the worst time of all.
Oh, I don't want to hear this.
What happened?
I split myself right down the middle. So, the tinsmith, who made me a new head and a new body, but along the way home, I got caught in a terrible rainstorm and lost it solid.
Wow. It just wasn't your day, was it?
I've been here ever since.
Well, you're perfect now.
Oh, my neck.
Oh.
My neck. Oh. Perfect. Oh, bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Come on. Bang on.
Oh, what a beautiful echo.
The tinsmith forgot a heart.
No heart?
No heart. Well, no, my heart never loved my munchkin babe again.
Oh, you tried to mend your rust again.
I used to carve her name on every tree.
You can say that.
Thank you.
sorry. I'm afraid I'm a little rusty yet.
Well, why don't you visit the tinsmith and ask him to give you a new part?
Well, he went out of business a long time ago. Ran out of tin.
Ran out of tin? Oh, why don't you come with us and ask the Wizard of Oz for a heart?
Oh, suppose we go all that way and he doesn't give me one when we get there.
Oh, he will. He must. We've come such a long way already.
You're the one who put a spell on my axe!
Oh, yes, it certainly cuts you down to size, take it! And now you're helping the lady along, aren't you, my fine gentleman? Well, stay away from her, or I'll stuff a mattress with you, Scarecrow. And Tinman, I'll use you for a bee.
I'm not afraid of you!
That just proves you don't have a brain. Allow me to educate you. Here, Tinman. Just remember, Tin Man, helping that little girl reach the Emerald City may be your last burning ambition.
I'm still not scared of her. I'll see if you get safely to the wizard, whether I need a brain or not. Stuff a mattress with me. Whether I get a heart or not, let her try to make a beehive out of me.
Oh, you are one of the bestest friends anyone could have ever asked for. Oh. It's funny. I feel like I've known you all the time. But I couldn't have, could I? Oh.
Well, I don't see how you could have. You weren't there when I was getting stoned and stuffed, were you? And I was rusted solid over there for the longest time.
Oh, I wish I could remember. Doesn't matter because we're friends now, aren't we?
That's right, we are. To us?
To us?
I'll get you anyway, Pee-wee. him by the butt.
No, but you tried to. It's bad enough for you being a straw man, but you were picking on poor dogs.
You didn't have to go and hit me, did you?
My nose bleeding.
My, what a big fuss you're making.
Apart. Good night.
effort is attractive, but messy.
Oh, I can't walk through.
Who rang that bell? Can't you read?
Read what?
The notice.
What notice?
It's on the door as plain as the nose on my face. Stop. Oh, one moment, please.
Bell out of order, please knock.
That's more like it. Now, state your business.
You want to see the wizard?
The wizard? Why? Nobody can see the wizard. Nobody's ever seen the wizard. Even I've never seen it.
Well, how do you know there is one?
Because. Well, if there wasn't a wizard, why would you be here?
I thought what the North sent me.
Ruby.
She's wearing the ruby slipper she gave her.
So she is. Well, bust my buttons. Why didn't you say that in the first place? That's a horse you can call.
Horse? Who is he calling a horse? Why? He wasn't on that side of the
road. He's coming up.
Oh, I assure you, every step is worth it. Do you know how wonderful this place really is?
I'm trying to imagine it, but I haven't got a brain.
They say I'd fall in love with it if I had a heart.
And it's the only place I don't need courage, because there's nothing to be afraid of, is there?
Thank you. Thank you.
we not know how?
Not even a rhinoceros?
Rhinoceros!
No, not a piece of parts!
I thrash it from top to bottom!
You! for a brain, you billowing bed of bovine butter?
Yes, Your Honor. I mean, Your Excellency. No, wait, I mean, Your Wizardry.
Enough! And you, liar. Well, silence, Whippersnapper! The Beneficent Oz has every intention of granting your requests.
What'd he say?
Are you all right?
Oof, a little deaf. What'd he say?
Oh, he's going to help us after all.
He is.
But first, you must prove yourselves worthy by performing a very small task.
A small task? Is that all?
David and it's half done.
Bring me the broomstick of the Witch of the West.
To do that, why? We'd have to kill her to get it.
Bring me her broomstick, and I'll grant your request. Now go.
But what if she kills us first?
I said, go!
I wish you'd given up this crazy scheme. I never should have let you see the wizard.
Oh, but I'm glad you did. We're all gonna get back to Kansas.
Oh, you don't have to worry about us.
We're not going after the witch empty-handed.
You can say that again.
Which way to the witch's castle?
No one knows for sure.
You say no one's ever been there.
Oh, no. Plenty folk have gone there. None have ever come back.
Oh, boy. There's no yellow brick road to follow now.
There's no road at all to the land of the Winkies.
Winkies? Much Winkies.
Well, once they were people much like us, until the Wicked Witch of the West captured them and made them her slaves. I hope the same thing doesn't happen to you.
So do I.
Keep going to the west where the sun sets.
Is that the best way to find the Wicked Witch?
Oh, no, Dorothy. You won't need to find the Wicked Witch. Once she knows you're in the land of the Winkies, she'll find you. Good night!
I guess it's a good thing not to have a brain. I have no one to be scared.
I have a heart to fail.
And I have it.
How can you betray Dorothy at a time like this?
I could stay here. That's one way.
Shame on you. You're even more of a coward than I thought.
Well, that's easy for you to say. You're made of straw. He's made of tin. I'm just weak flesh. Oh,
very weak.
Working on flabby.
That's all right, fine. You can stay here if you'd like. Oh,
but I guess you need a tiger tag on you.
Oh, that's more like it!
Oh, stout fellow!
Oh, ready to go, Dorothy?
Best foot forward!
Precision.
Come on, Lion!
Scarecrow's not the only one who can play.
What does it mean?
Nico! Nico, where is the commander of my diplomatic apes?
Thank you.
all over.
Oh.
So how did you get yourself in there?
I went, but I can't.
I'm there. I'm there.
Oh.
Oh.
canceled.
It might not work.
It might not work.
But it's got a chance.
It's got a chance.
The only thing is, it's very, very dangerous. What do you say?
I say, anyone else got a plan?
Oh, let's hear the scarecrows.
First, we need to get our hands on 3 winky unicorns.
How are we ever going to find 3 winky unicorns?
Fellas.
I don't know, but the plan is crucial for it.
3 winky unicorns.
Fellas. I don't think we have to go very far.
Oh, well, why is that?
They're right behind us.
Yeah.
there! Oh! Can I believe my eyes? Why have you come back?
Sir, we've done it. You've laughed at us. We killed the Wicked Witch of the West. We melted her.
Oh, you liquidated her, eh? Very resourceful.
Yes, so we'd like you to keep your promise to us, if you please.
Not so fast. Not so fast. I'll have to give the man who even thought. Go away. Come back tomorrow.
You've had plenty of time already.
Yeah. Do not arouse the wrath of the great and powerful Oz. I said come back tomorrow.
No, if you were really great and powerful, then you'd keep your promises.
Do you presume to criticize the great Oz? You ungrateful creatures. Think yourselves lucky that I am giving you an audience tomorrow instead of 20 years from now. The great Oz has spoken. Now go! I said go! Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. Pay!
Who are you?
I am a great and powerful Wizard of Oz.
I don't believe you!
Yes, well, I'm afraid it's true. There is no other wizard here except for me.
Oh, you humbug!
Yeah.
Yes, I'm afraid that's also true. I am a humbug.
Oh, you're a very bad man.
Oh, no, I'm actually a very good man. I'm just not a very good wizard.
Well, what about the heart and the brain?
And scarecrow's brain.
What? Anybody can have a brain? That's a very mediocre commodity. That's where I come from. We have universities where men go all day long to become great thinkers, and when they come out, they think big thoughts, and they have no more brains than you do. But they have one thing you do not have. A diploma! Therefore, by the power vested in me by the Universitatis Committeatum e Pluribus Unum, I hereby bestow upon you the honorary degree of Ph.D.
Ph.D.?
Yes, that's Doctor of Thinkology.
Oh, the sum of the square root of an isosceles triangle is equal to the square root of the remaining sides. Oh, oh, rapture, oh, joy! Oh, how can I have said so much? You can't, you can't.
And as for you, my fine friend, you are under the unfortunate illusion that because you run from danger, you have no courage. My friend, you are confusing courage for wisdom. Back where I come from, we have men called heroes. And every year, they clear their fortitudes out of the mothballs, and they march themselves down to the city center. And they have no more courage than you do. But they have one thing that you do not have. Ah, yes. A medal. Therefore, for meritorious conduct and conspicuous bravery. Conspicuous bravery against wicked witches, I hereby bestow upon you the Triple Cross. You are now a member of the Legion of Courage. And as for you, my galvanized friend, you want a heart. You have no idea how lucky you are not to have one. A heart can never be made practical unless it can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Back where I come from, we have men who do nothing but good deeds all day long. They are called good deed doers. And they have no more heart than you do. But they have one thing you do not have. A testimonial.
Therefore, we are proud to present you this small token of our esteem and affection. And remember, my sentimental friend, that a heart is not judged by how much you love, but by how much you are loved by others.
Oh, listen to my heart. Oh, it ticks. Oh, listen to it.
Read what it says. Oh, it's the truth. Thank you, the truth.
What about Dorothy?
Yes, Dorothy.
Well, I don't think there's anything in there for me.
Well, I'm afraid you forced me into a cataclysmic decision. The only way for Dorothy to return home is for me to take her myself.
Oh, would you? Oh, could you? Are you a clever enough wizard to manage it?
Oh, child, you cut me to the quick. I'm an old Kansas man myself.
Oh.
Premier balloonist. Par excellence of the Miracle Wonderland Carnival Company, until one day, while performing extraordinary feats of the stratospheric skill never before seen by civilized man, the balloon failed to return to the fair.
Frightened, were you?
No, frightened. You are looking at a man who has laughed in the face of death, sneered at doom, and chuckled at catastrophe. I'm petrified. Then suddenly, the wind changed, and the balloon slowly drifted down into the center of the city, where I was instantly acclaimed Oz, the first wizard deluxe. Deluxe from French. There were a few luxuries that came with the job, but I took it anyway, retaining the balloon against the advent of the quick getaway. The balloon isn't quite ready, and, well, in that conveyance, Dorothy, you and I shall return to the land of E. Pluribus Unum. Step this way.
Thank you.
always had the power to go back to Kansas.
I have?
Oh, then why didn't you tell her sooner? Because she wouldn't have believed me. She had to learn it for herself.
Oh, well, then, what did you learn, Dorothy?
Well, I learned that it isn't enough just to want to see Uncle Henry and Auntie Anne. If I ever go looking for my heart's desire again, I shouldn't look any further than my own backyard. Because if it isn't there, I never really lost it to begin with. Is that right?
That's all it is.
Oh, that's so easy. I should have thought it for you. You should have felt it in my heart.
Me too, if I had had the courage of my convictions.
No, she had to find it out for herself. And now those silly slippers will take you home in 2 seconds.
Oh, Toto too?
Toto too.
Oh, it's going to be so hard to say goodbye. I love you all so very much. Goodbye, Timmy. Don't cry, you'll rest again. Here's your oil can. Goodbye.
No, I really do know I have a heart, but it's breaking.
Lion, I know he's a fighter. I'm going to miss the way you used to call him before you found your courage.
I'm going to do some problems.
Oh, goodbye. You scarecrow. You're my best friend, dear. I think I'll miss you most of all.
Having a brain don't make saying goodbye any easier. Goodbye, Dorothy. I'll think of you always.
Are you ready now?
Please, before I change my mind and stay forever.
Then close your eyes and tap your heels together 3 times. And think to yourself over and over. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Two.
There's no place like home.
Goodbye, Dorothy.
think of her out there in the storm all night alone.
Oh, that's getting tired of the front, Sheriff.
Wait! Toto! Here she is!
Dorothy! Dorothy! Zeke! Come on, Hickory! She's over here! Tell Emmy you've been very blinded!
She's got a bump on her head the size of an ostrich egg, but her little skin ain't broke.
Hello, Oz!
Oz! Well, name's Chester, but you can call me whatever you like.
Oh, Uncle Henry, you remind me of the guard.
I'm guarding you with all my life now, honey. I'll see you coming to no more harm.
Is she all right?
She'll be fine. There was a minute there when I thought she left us.
Oh, but I did leave, Uncle Henry. That's just the trouble. And I tried to get back for days and days.
Sounds just like a bad dream to me.
Oh, but it wasn't a dream.
Sure, it wasn't, honey, but you remember your old pal Zeke, don't you?
The lion!
No, Zeke, you intended as Hickory.
Hey, you remember my face, don't you?
Well, of course, but where's Scarecrow?
Scarecrow? I got the blanket you asked for.
Oh!
How is she?
She's doing all right, she'll be fine.
Well, what happened to all your stuffing?
Stuffing?
What happened to the mother field mouse in your stomach?
Mother field mouse? No, you gave me like a whole sack of kittens in there.
Dorothy! Oh, Annie Ann!
You're safe and well.
Oh, thanks to you, Annie Ann. You showed me I had the power to come home all along.
You are home.
You never let us. What? No. No. This is a real, truly live place. And I remember. It wasn't very nice. Most of it was beautiful. And you were all there. And you kept resting up. And you kept pulling on your own tail. And you were a humbug.
Let's not get personal.
Doesn't anyone believe me?
Of course we believe you, Dorothy. But now we have to get you to bed.
Oh, what happened to the house? It fell on a witch, you know.
No. The storm blew right past it.
It wasn't a house that fell on this gulch.
It was a telegraph pole.
Oh, yeah, we won't hear from that old bitty Toto. Leg is out of plastic.
Then Toto's safe. Oh, Toto. We're safe and left.
Thank you.
Jim.